स्टूडेंट्स और गुड आफ्टरनून। आर यू हियरिंग माय वॉइस? स्टूडेंट्स आर यू हियरिंग माय वॉइस?
यस सर।
ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी discussed about women's organizations or women's associations in pre-independence period. That too, the organizations which established by male particular. Okay, so today we are going to see about the women organizations which established by the women themselves. Okay, so we see these as the second place within the pre-independence period. Okay, so I will give you certain women organizations which played an important role in uplift the status of the women. Basically in the colonial period, and along with various organizations and associations, how those women contributed a lot towards the development of women, and to eradicate such social levels only confined to the women in the Indian traditional society. Okay, so I will give you the women organizations which founded by the women after the support of the male. Basically, the women himself want to establish such associations, organizations, and certain clubs which only confined to the women. Okay, so the women began to define their interests, propose solutions, and take action only after they formed their own associations. And women's associations, called by various titles, sprang up all over India in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, and most were geographically limited, but they shared the goal of bringing women together to discuss the women issues basically. Okay, so they want to discuss separately the women issues they want to independent. Okay, so Sarala Devi Chaudhary, the critical of women's meetings held in conjunction with the Indian National Social Conference, called for a permanent association of Indian women, and women responded favorably, and Sarala Devi began planning the first meeting, and when male colleagues criticized her, she charged them with patronizing women. Okay, so even though when the male criticized, though Sarala Devi, she want to start a separate organization with only the men, sorry, only the women. Okay, and Sarala Devi's organization, the Bharat Stri Mahamandal, which is the large circle of Indian women, had its first meeting in Allahabad in 1910. Okay, so the Bharat Stri Mahamandal planned to open branches in all parts of India to promote female education, and it developed branches in Lahore, Allahabad, Delhi, Karachi, Amritsar, Hyderabad, Kanpur, Hazirabad, and Kolkata. Like, okay, so Kolkata to bring together such a women of every race, creed, class and party on the basis of their common interest in the moral and material progress of women of India. Okay. So, and the Mahamandal's leaders regarded Parada as the main stumbling block to the popular acceptance of education. To get around this practice, they could send teachers to the homes to teach reading, writing, and music, sewing, and embroidery. And Sarala Devi had written about the importance of women escaping male domination. So only women were allowed to join this organization, and most of the members had worked previously with male-dominated women's organizations and designed projects similar to those favored by male reformers. Okay, so and women leaders who were defining women's issues as the female education, child marriage, the observance of Parada, and the women status, women status in the family, and many of them believe all women share the same problems. Okay, so clearly they spoke from specific class orientation, but they did so at that time when there was considerably prejudice against female education. Okay, so female education and child marriages was preferred. Okay, so and a widow remarriage was unheard of in respectable families. Okay, so and when they assumed all women experienced difficulties within laws, they were drawing on experience, their evolution of women's status in the family was based on their knowledge of laws and personal observation. Okay, so and when you see such national organizations after this, I will give you one or two things before going to national women organizations like Women's Indian Association and National Council of Women in India and All India Women's Conference, which emerged in between 1917 to 1927. Okay, so before that, I have to share my screen and then I will explain. Students, are you getting my screen? Screen kanipistunda?
Yes, sir.
Kanipistundi.
Yeah, right. So, they started establishing various. Various such organizations to support the women and to solve their problems and eradicate such a women such a social evils which only confined to the women in the society. And the rural poor would not have been able to send their daughters to schools even if they favored female education. And widow homes were suitable for women from respectable families who needed to earn some more money, but often these homes were restricted to only the Brahmin widows. and handicraft production, particularly sewing and embroidery, enabled only some high caste women to earn a living because they had access to such an clients. Okay, so and homes they could live in and a space to work. Okay, so Jay Z Lam, widowed in 1898, at the age of 28, with two children, earned a living embroidery sarees. She was famous for her skill in Chinese embroidery, then the rage in women's fashion, and was able to support herself and her children in a respectable manner. But the family standard of living was not due to her earnings alone. Her husband left her some property. Okay, so in defining women's problems and suggesting suitable remedies, the founders of the early women's organization tended to look at women's like Jay Z Lam, okay, so as a model. Okay, so consequently their institutions were able to serve some of the unfortunate women for their own class, but few others. Okay, so after the First World War, during the time of First World War and after ending the First World War, the such national women's organizations was created. Those are particularly the three such types of organizations: Women's Indian Association and the National Council of Women in India and the All India Women's Conference, which emerged in between 1917 and 27. Okay, so I will start with the first, the Women's Indian Association. The Women's Indian Association had humble beginnings, and Margaret Cousins, an Irish feminist, theosophist and a musician, arrived in India in 1915. And soon after, an officer of the Theosophical Society in Adyar invited a number of women to meet with her. After this meeting, Cousins spoke with Dorothy Jinardhan Dasa, an Irish feminist married to a respected Sinhalese theosophist, Jinardhan Dasa, Jinara Dasa, and about forming the women organization. Okay, so many of the Indian women already belonged to the Tamil Mother Sangam, Tamil Ladies Association, and had joined British women in forming the National Indian Association. Okay, so Indian National Indian Association to promote female education, particularly English language instruction and the teaching of crafts. Okay, so as the two groups began to mix more freely, they decided to form the ladies recreational club to sponsor tea parties and playing such a sports like the badminton and tennis. And these Margaret Cousins and Jinara Dasa,